Iisus și Hristos. My case was supposed to be to upper tribunal, but my solicitor was saying no, you have to make fresh claim. And on fresh claim, he was saying I should pay money worth to £1,000. I said I don't have money. How can I pay money? Yet I've got money. I'm under support. So it was a battle. I told him I cannot pay money unless we go fresh claim. Even the home office knows that it's on fresh, it's on upper tribunal. He kept on refusing. Then myself, I just said to say that I will be called to the upper tribunal for hearing. And then after they didn't take me out of the house. I went to the machine, cash machine. I put the cash machine. I found there's no money. I asked my friends, have you got money? They said, yes, we've got money. Then I said, that means my and I've left it. Then the following day, I received a letter. They said, you have to move the house. Your case is failed. And so what? You are HC2. You are not going to get HC2 for the hospital. Everything. I said, where do I go? I don't have a place where to go. Then I called my solicitor. I told him, what has happened to my case? Yet my case, it was on the upper tribunal. You are saying now, I'm saying now I should remove it, has failed. He said, yeah, Joyce, your case it needs a fresh claim. I told you already, you need to pay £1,000. I said, is it me to pay or the government? Because all along it has been the government. They said, no, now we have to pay, it's you. So I said, I went to the solicitor, I come to your office. I went to the office of him. He still said, no, the same thing, you have to pay £1,000. Now, it was the day of departure. They came, they said, you have to move this house. I said, I've got nowhere. Give me where to go then. I called Brother Erwin. I told him. Then they said, you should move. Then I called his sister Chisasa. I said, sister, can you help me, Brother Joshua, to come and take my things to put in the house so that I can be at your house? Then the Chisasas, they granted me, okay. The Brother Joshua traveled from Nottingham to pick me to be Birmingham to house. Then there, I went to Derby. I was working there in Derby. I said, I should not just stay. I was working for the child. Then, the persisted to say that, you know, your case has failed. Then I said, then if it has failed, because you want to be me to be on the street, at my age, I cannot be on the street. I've been in this country for a long time, and now you say I must be on the street. What if then I go home, I go to Malawi, than me being on the street? Then they said, we'll answer you even for 5 days. I kept on saying, the things, they're at Chisasa, myself, Mindabe. Then last week is when they called me. They said, Joyce, we have accepted you are going home. I said, okay, fine. So how am I traveling to go home? They said, we'll give you a ticket. I said, fine. Give me the ticket, I'll go. I stayed. Then it passed 4 days. Then they sent a ticket to my email. A ticket on 12th October that I should go home. Then I said, my passport is expired. I don't have something to use. What am I going to use? I use the travel document. Am I paying for travel document? They said you go to the embassy to take travel document from embassy, and then you say you sign it, then you give us. I went as far as London. All these years, these days I've not been coming to church. I've been busy. I went to embassy to take the travel document. The embassy, they sent me back. They said, no, it doesn't work like this. It's Home Office, we're supposed to do this. Why are they troubling you? I said, I don't know. I came back again, and then I got them. And then they said, you know, now the travel document you have to pay because your passport is missing, we're not seeing it. I said, my passport is missing. Wow, you kept my passport, so how am I going to go? Your ticket, I've got it. Then the last day, then they said, no, the social worker, I reported to the city council of Birmingham. When I traveled there to come to Birmingham city council, they said, can you talk to the Home Office? Because they are saying I should pay my travel document. They are supposed to pay. They don't give money. They evicted me for no reason. Can you talk to them? Then they talked to them. Then they said, yeah, no, okay, now we'll give her the money for travel document. She should just be waiting and looking to her email. I kept on checking to my email, no coming. Then I left Derby, coming to here, Birmingham, at Dudley. A certain lady was saying, come and work these jobs, small jobs for caring for children. Then I came there for 1 week. I've been there on Dudley there. As there, then the lady was saying, if they're troubling me for travel document now, why can't I give you this £5? It's just £5. You should go and send the forms so that you can finish with them. I got the form, I filled. I got two photo passport or photographs. I traveled to Smithwick. As I reached on the step of the post office, I heard a phone from Home Office. I said, they said, no, you should not go and pay the money. We have paid for you. I said, thank Lord for this money. That means last minute you are saying that I'm going back though. Then I took the money. I came to tell people more. They have called me. They said they have paid the travel document. Then they said, no, you should phone the embassy, Malawi embassy, to find out before you go again. Because the Home Office told you, you should go there and money to collect. I reached there, I phoned them, the Malawi embassy. Has the Home Office called you that they have paid for your travel document? The embassy said, no, they haven't called us. The Home Office have just notified us through email that the travel document, we will pay for it. So the date is set, it's 12 October, that I'm going to Malawi. Now, I'm just waiting on tomorrow is Monday, on Tuesday. I'll go to the doctor and then I'll call them if they have confirmed that they have got money for travel document so that I can get the travel document. They said I should travel again to London to collect travel document. Yeah. That is the battle I've been facing. All is well. Yeah.
Amen.
In fact, we have got no home here. Our home is heaven. Even you, even me. Even I go to Malawi, it's not my home, Malawi. Here is not my home. My home is in heaven. I said, fine. Now, I'll just be waiting for them. So then this morning, yesterday, I called Isaac. Isaac, can you please take me to church? Because these people, I don't know their make. Whether I go, whether not, they might take me, they might say go quickly. I might not say bye to my fellow church members. If they are special people, I have to say thank you very much for your prayers. They are the bride.
Amen.
So that's why I'm here, to say thank you very much for your prayers. Oh, it's well. God answers differently. He can answer to stay. He can answer to go. But for us, we don't have to worry. All is well, because we are going to heaven. Even all of you, you are waiting for heaven, crying for heaven. If they were unbelievers, They would have been, ah, no, I stay here. But we are going to heaven. What we are crying for is the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
So that we can fly and meet Jesus Christ. So that is my testimony. It's not my testimony as such, but it's to say bye to you, my fellow bride. Yeah. But then they told me, I said, so how long was it? They told me, well, we'll give you travel ban for 2 years, not to come to UK. Because now your case has failed. I said, okay, fine, 2 years is just at the door. I'll come or I'll not come. I'll go, or if I don't come, we'll meet to heaven.
Yeah,
sure. Yeah. For blessing, we'll meet to heaven. Thank you.
If there was a funny side to it, I could see that. I do that. It's just certainly got me in a circle. But she knows what she's talking about. She knows what she's saying. Hallelujah. And so, Joyce, keep trusting the Lord.
Amen. Always.
You see the yes or no? Amen. The promises of God. Paul says, you know about the promises of God. Is it that not no, they are yes and amen in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
God bless you. Amen. Shall we stand now as our brother comes?